Welcome to Information Service Engineering. This is Lecture 1, Information, Natural Language and the Web. In this section, we will be talking about search engines on the web. Imagine the web without the search engine. How would we get along? Just think, you only would have, let's say, a list of URIs which you can click on, and then you would have to go connection by connection, wandering through this immense network of things. So without being able to directly search for something, the web was somehow useless. You needed something like a search engine in the beginning. And search engines over time, they have made tremendous progress. So here you have an example. So this is the search engine Bing. And here I wanted to look for climate change. And what you see here while typing, actually, you already get suggestions on how to continue. So this is an auto continuation or auto-suggestion, what you could search there. So this is a kind of auto-completion, and some of these internet search engines, they already provide instant search, which means you get already results while you are typing. They are using knowledge graphs, we have already seen that, to answer also your questions, so you have question answering. They do not only contain dedicated web documents, but they have channels for news, they have specific search facilities for images, also for video data. They give you recommendations, so if you haven't found what you are looking for, what could be interesting, what is related to your search, they give you quotes and they give you the possibility also to do shopping, so for e-commerce. And so on and so on. So search engines really are something tremendous, and without them we would not get along on the web, so we wouldn't find anything. Okay, let's look at the web. Long form, the World Wide Web. The World Wide Web is a distributed hypermedia system. So this means it contains multimedia documents, so every web page contains usually of some text, you have images, you might have videos, you might have audio recordings, and so on. So it's a multimedia document. And the fanciest thing about these web documents is they are interconnected via so-called hyperlinks. One document links to another document. And you know that you simply click on something, either it's a picture or it's an underlined text. And what happens is you will be transferred in your browser to the next document. So this is a hyperlinked network of multimedia documents. And within this network of documents, you are using search engines. With that, you always find what you are looking for, don't you? This is an example from Google Image Search. So what did I search? What was I looking for? Of course, you might say he was looking for Jaguar. But you might see the dilemma here. Of course, I find different things which have probably the same name. So it's difficult then to express really my search intent based on the language I'm using. Another thing, so what's the information on this website? And I'm asking especially people who are not fluent, let's say in Japanese. So you have no idea. So what a search engine has to determine also is which information is important on a web page. And how do you know what is important on a web page? Which information that you see can be trusted? This is even a more, let's say, complicated question. And which information is related by content with each other? And overall, what does this information mean? Please tell me, because I have to know the meaning to understand the information. This exactly we have already talked about what understanding is all about. So the machine to be able to make right assumptions about what you're seeing here, it must understand the information. Thereby, it must be able to interpret it correctly. Humans possess a lot of contextual knowledge, of world knowledge, of experience to solve these kind of problems, because they did it, they do it in their normal life, so they can also transfer their experiences on the web. They know language, they know the world around them, and they get along pretty well to solve exactly these kind of questions we have seen there. So the web, especially the document web, not the web of data, is made for humans, simply because the web is based on the markup language HTML, so the hypertext markup language. You have for sure heard about that. And HTML, in which each web document is encoded, this describes how information is presented, and it describes how information is linked among each other, so which document is linked to which other document. but it does not describe what the information really means, because the meaning of the content is encoded within the natural language that is given, for example, in a document. And this, of course, requires interpretation. Moreover, this natural language, as we have seen in our example with the jaguar, has the problem of ambiguity. So natural language always is ambiguous, and it is this on different levels. We will see this later on when we do natural language processing. So this you also call polysemy. And on the other hand, the same thing, the same concept, the same information can be expressed with different words. So you can use synonyms, you can use metaphors, you can use some paraphrases or whatever. So you have different ways to express exactly the same. And this, again, is another complexity that we have to solve. And that makes the understanding of information even more complicated. Okay, I guess now we have reached a point. Now we should talk about understanding and how is the meaning in information expressed. So how do we get to the meaning of information? And this exactly, the meaning of information, will be the subject of the last chapter of this lecture.